It's come to my attention that some of you don't know what a worm threader is or how to use it. So in a few short minutes, I'm going to explain to you how to use a worm threader, why you'd want to use one, and also when you would never want to use a worm threader, plus how to not stick yourself with one of these things, which is no fun. So why bother to use a worm threader? Well, it all comes down to presentation. In general, most fish, like trout for example, are going to attack a nice straight worm more readily than they will a balled up worm because it looks more natural to them. It's just going to create that instinctive bite that you're looking for. Of course, the smell of a worm is still there, and a fish like a catfish, maybe they don't care so much, but trout, I can tell you from experience, they love the worm threaded up your line so it looks nice and natural as it's drifting by them. And this is particularly effective when drift fishing. Not that you can't use it in ponds and lakes as well, that's a really good way to go. But when you're casting and drifting down a stream, that natural straight presentation is just unbeatable. A worm threader is simply a steel tube with a sharp point made into it, a lot like a hypodermic needle. So this is hollow, and there's a hole in the end of it. And I'm going to show you right now how you thread a worm. So you'll take a nice fat night crawler, and of course bigger night crawlers are a lot easier to do this with than a little red worm or something like that. We've got a nice fat night crawler with a head and a tail. So we're going to take the tail end, take the tip of this, and just shove it right up the kazoo. They squirm around, so it's kind of hard to get hold of them sometimes, but get control of him. And there we go. We're just going to go the whole length of the worm, or as close to it as we can. Some people like to leave the tail hanging out or not go all the way up to the head. But if your goal is to make the worm straight, then the more of the worm on the worm threader, the better. So we'll go all the way up like that. Boop. There you go. That worm's on the steel shank, ready to be threaded onto your hook and line. So I've got a number two bait holder hook here that I've snelled on. Snelling is better than just tying onto the eye of the hook. If you don't know how to snell a hook, there is a video I have. I've got the link down below in the description. It's with Buzz Ramsey showing how to snell a hook. Very simple. So you're going to hold your hook in one hand like this, the worm threader like this. Then you're just going to take the tip of the hook and put it right into the hole at the end of the worm threader. Now the only real trick to this is to know that you need to hold your line tight. Okay, so this is the line that would be coming from your rod. This is your leader. So I'm going to take it down to about almost the end of the worm threader. I'm going to wrap it around my finger, maybe twice, so I get a good grip on it. And then I'm going to hold the worm threader in the same hand as the line. So the line's being held nice and tight here. And I'm kind of giving it some pressure with my thumb. You see that? And then just push the worm right on to the hook and the line, and we'll push it right down on there, all the way down to where the hook's sticking out, the worm, the tail of the worm there, and now there you go, a perfectly straight, nice presentation that will catch fish. Now there's no doubt that a threaded worm like this is awesome for catching fish, but you've got to have some ethics and some common sense with this. If you're fishing for fish that you might have to release, then you don't want to use this technique. It's just not the right thing to do. They'll eat it deep, it'll get in their gills, it'll get down into their guts, and it's just not right to fish for fish that you're going to release with this sort of a setup. In particular, steelhead. You know, steelhead will hit this rig for sure, absolutely guaranteed. But there's a chance that that's not going to be a fish that's going to live if you release it. And if you're fishing for steelhead, you're probably fishing around wild fish that have to be released. So it wouldn't be right to use something like this. But if you're fishing a stock pond or a stock stream for a limit of trout, this is an extremely effective way to go. Now here's a valuable little item you might want to have with you when you're using a worm threader. It's simply a wine cork. And what I've done is taken an 1/8-inch drill bit and just drilled a little hole right into the middle of it, because these things are like hypodermic needles, big, strong, nasty needles. And when you're reaching down into your tackle box or your bag or wherever and you stick yourself with one of these things, you're gonna know about it right away and you're gonna wish you had something to protect the tip of your point there. So that just goes right in there like that, and that will save you in the long run. So I hope you enjoyed this video. We have worm threaders in the shop here in Woodland, Washington available for a couple bucks. You can sure catch a lot more fish if you start threading your worms. Please subscribe and we'll have some more videos for you soon.